Good afternoon, everybody. Today we will be jumping back into Final Fantasy V, seeing what progress we can make in that. And I don't think we're going to beat it today by any means, but we will see just how far we can get today. It's been a little while since we've been on. So, feels like Final Fantasy V's been going on forever, so definitely would like to complete it when we can. So where we left off, we were gathering up the tablets to to unlock and get to where Xdeath is. We've gotten two of the four, and we got some of the ultimate weapons here at the castle. So now we need to go to the Fork Tower, which is down by where Crescent Island used to be. And I definitely did not mean to go into the void again. Kilo, how are you, sir? Love your Pepe Frog with the lightsabers. That's classic. Maybe I'm thinking of something else, because I could swear there was a, there's like a hidden town in these woods. Oh, I've been doing real good. It's been crazy busy, but lately that seems like the name of the game. When I'm not at work, I'm busy in life, and, you know, yeah. But, yeah, I've been thinking about you, hoping you're holding up okay, because I know your wisdom teeth are coming out on Thursday, so yeah, I've been hoping you're doing okay. I must be thinking about something else, because I could swear there was a hidden town in one of these woods, but, yeah. Yeah. No, I feel you there, and I'm definitely good luck to you on it. It's, yeah. Not to make things sound scary, you know, it is a big surgery, so just take care of yourself. To give you guys an idea as to why I haven't been on as much lately, my to-do list has been multiplying. Here, we'll move my webcam for a second so y'all can get an idea. So there's my to-do list, which I have knocked it down to 5 post-it notes, whereas it was... when I left last episode, it was, I think, 14 or 15 post-its. Oh, no. Thank you so much. The 5 left on here are the big ones. My son was looking at them the other day, and he's like, why don't you just do them? And I'm like, well, all 5 of those are actually in progress things. You know, I'm just like... I have to wait for more information, or in some case, you know, some documentation. Some of those are doctor's appointments. Some are, like, I gotta call the state of Florida and fuss with them because they're giving me problems with my driver's license and like, oh man, it's a mess. But yeah, I'm so sorry about your kid getting lice, man. That sucks. I've never had to deal with it myself, but one of my friends had it growing up, and oof. Again, I am so sorry. Yeah, on the plus side, you know, I've got my to-do list there, and then, seeing, my webcam's not really gonna stretch very well. Let's see. Yeah, it's not gonna stretch. I'm trying to show off my Lego collection, which is that shelf. But, you know, I'll take a picture and post it on my, on my page or something. I've been thinking about, starting a Twitter for the show so that I can let y'all know in advance, you know, like, hey, this is a guaranteed day at a guaranteed time that I'm gonna be on. But, you know, we'll add it to the to-do list. Oh, yeah. Yeah, did you have to shave her completely, or is it like you're trying to get through with the treatments first? And I appreciate that. You know, I feel bad because I know that I'm more sporadic than I would like to be jumping on. There we go. You heard it here first, folks. By the next episode, I'll have set up a Twitter. You had to listen. Oh, I gotcha. Well, absolutely good luck on that. I can understand. Not that I can understand, because again, I never went through it, but I understand how frustrating it can be as a parent to, you know, have to go through those tough things with your kids. If the spells aren't taken from both towers at the same time, the towers explode, right? I guess we better split up then. Bart's will go over here. Lena, who is my white mage, will go with Bart's. And then the other two will go on the other side. Right here. I have literally zero memory of doing this, so hopefully it goes well. Can't remember. Whoa! It's fucked, dude. Drinking my son's top secret lemonade mix, We've got the big canisters of country time. So he made about half the powder that you should for a 2 liter. And then added like a cup of sugar. I'm like, so tasty. So yeah, we ended up having to pour like half of it out and then add a little bit more of the country time powder and then just fill it with water so it wasn't quite so mouth destroying. What the fuck? What the fuck was that? Let's raise old Bart's. Seriously. I'm assuming that means that I can't hit him with physical attacks, that I gotta smack him with the magic. I should probably heal before I go much further. Ether. Trip bio on these bitches. Oh, you dicks. Okay, let's try Blue Saga. Yeah, not too bad. So cold is your friend in this place, it seems. Sorry, I'm not sure what that means. Right. Sorry, my bad. Definitely the telling these bitches to cool off is, or you know, using Quake on them. Boom. Definitely stick with Blizzogging most of these bitches. Yeah, when you said, so cold is your friend in this place, it seems. I thought you were making a shrinkage joke because they use tiny on Barts. So I'm like, wait, is that like a shrinkage joke? And I'm like, huh? My brain definitely didn't want to get up on the intake on that one. My muscles are more irony than you, iron muscle. Oh, no, it's all good. You have to take it at exactly the same time. Take it red when I do. What? I picked it up, did you? What? Oh, did you just silence me, you bitch? Oh, shit. No, I didn't mean to use eye drops. Oh, you bitch. Oh, no! I'm not certain I have anything for being silenced in this. I think that might just be something I have to wait out in this one. Weapons for now? Yeah, because in that empty blue box next to Krill, it would show that she was silenced. So, why is she not able to cast right now? So strange. I mean, unless this guy suddenly pulls out the big guns, you know, I think we're okay. It'll just take a few minutes to actually kill him, because this is going to take a while. Mm-hmm. right, dude, you can leave Ferris alone for a minute. Oh, you bitch. This bitch moves fast. I'll smack you with my rod. Yeah, 44 whole points. Eat that, bitch. I'm really not sure how many times I've hit him so far, but it seems like he's got more life than he should. I mean, each jump I'm taking close to 2,000 off of him. The power of holy magic. I think it's time you tasted its might. What a dumbass. It's time for you to taste its might. Oh shit. We don't take it quick, the whole tower will blow. I don't have holy yet. Holy is in Final Fantasy IV, holy is called white. So it's just like a really strong magic attack for white mages. And I was really hoping that it would give it to me already, but that's all right. What the fuck? Okay, I know what he's doing. So the Minotaur I couldn't hit with magic because they couldn't let me use magic. This guy I can't use regular attacks with, or he'll reset the whole fucking match. to. I'll see if using the spell sword will actually... Fuck. It's alright. This battle is gonna suck. He's like, meh, bring it on, bitch. He's like, I'm gonna make your friend croak. Oops, the wrong version. At all. See if this helps anyway. Feeling this guy's gonna take a while, so I'm gonna check real quick if there's any better magic to use against this guy. Okay, so. Nope, definitely don't want to do that. Ten 1,000, vulnerable to wind. I don't have Arawaga, I think that's a Time Mage spell. Vanilla. You can take this guy, it just is gonna take a few minutes. Oh, well. Thank you. Yeah, you just silence yourself, dumbass. I guess it doesn't matter then. Almost out of magic points, so let's go ahead and get on that then. That's not very nice. I wish, man. Fucking Rochambeau him. Like, how's this for defensive magic? Crunch! You're welcome to die anytime, dude. I would prefer him to stay alive, just so, you know, get somebody to help me heal up sometimes. Oh, you bitch! Oh, okay, good. It's like, that Blizzaga is going to murder me. Shit. This is bad. This is really bad. Come on. Fuck! Come on, dude. Give me a fucking break. Fuck. Fuck. All right. Well, I'm going to have to switch Bartz over to a mage for this battle. Jeez, it felt like it. You know what? Actually, what we are going to do is I'm just going to have my two mages go on. Yeah. No, it... Not that I'm opposed to saying fuck on my show, but yeah, it was definitely a... I'm going to bite my lip for a minute on this one. Oh, fuck. There. Fuck this guy. Oh, it's Fork Tower, too. But, I mean, it sure feels like it should be Fuck Tower. Alright. I'm gonna send my two warriors on the right side. And then my two magicians on the left. All right. Chrono controller. Yeah, we're not playing Chrono Trigger yet. Maybe 2025 we'll play Chrono Trigger. And I don't care about the ether. Stop! That was easy enough. Bart's losing life with the thornlet. Yeah, that would do it. Yeah, now I really wish, now I wish X-Death had a Fuck Tower. Yeah, be like, yeah, you've been doing a great job. You know, you get to spend 1 week in the fuck tower. It's like, all right. All right, so I gotta switch Ferris's lance, or I just give that stupid fucker life every time I hit him. Excalibur is gonna give him life too. Not cool, dude. Alright, might have to start breaking out some elixirs here. Seriously, Jesus Christ. Maybe I'm a little overconfident in trying to have two warriors on this side instead of one warrior, one mage. But whatevs. Holy magic. It is time you tasted its might. Holy! No magic. Don't have holy yet. Alright. What the fuck just happened? What the fuck? What the hell just happened? That's never happened. You know, in all seriousness, Kilo, I was like, if I go and my file is gone, like the whole thing just wrecked down, then I'm like, yeah, it would be a time for Final Fantasy VI. Because, damn, was I like, that may have just ruined my entire life. Wow. That was something else. Yeah, X-Death's like, time for my most feared magic of all, the reset button. It's like, you bitch. So, what they're doing here to us in the Fork Tower is actually a big reason why I don't like Final Fantasy VIII. Because, like, in every Final Fantasy game, you get used to using one set of characters. They're your A-team, essentially. Final Fantasy VIII keeps splitting you up, and it drives me fucking insane. I'm like, I don't want to use these characters. And it's like, nope, too bad, you have to. So then you have to stop and you have to grind a bunch. Because you haven't used these characters since, you know, you ditched them, you know, back at the end of Disc 1, you know? Of all the Final Fantasies, though, 8 is the only one I have not beaten. Or I should say, of the ones we're doing, 1 through 10. Because, I mean, I haven't beaten 12, I beat 13. 14's the online one. 15 I beat, but, like, I really had to force myself to play it. Like, 15 was it was a hard game to get through, because it didn't have a fun story, and then I found out... Yeah, they really are forking me over, man. With 15, I found out that there, to get to know what the full story is about, you've got to watch... the movie that they made. There's a companion book you need to read. There's a mobile game you have to play. And, like, all this extra prep shit. And it was like, I just want to play and enjoy the game. Don't give me homework. 2, 4, 7, 9, 10. Yeah, I mean, that is a good set to play. As I've gone on record numerous times, 6 is my favorite of the series. But, like, they all have their pluses. The only one that I 100% hate, just kill me sort of hate, is Final Fantasy II. Not the American Final Fantasy II, but the actual II. Again, not saying you have to, but, you know, I recorded the entire session playing through 2. It's on my YouTube channel. What I'd recommend for people, because, I mean, that's a good 20 to 25 hours of me playing, is maybe watch, like, the last hour, and you can see how pissed I am. Like, I am fucking furious at that game, and I was about to throw my controller out the window. I was so angry. Like with all the other games, it's like, okay, you've got jobs for each character, and this and that, and blah, blah, blah. Let's see, web page. In order to level up your magic, you have to, you've got to use it continuously, and then the game will be like, okay, maybe I'll level it up. Like, there's like a 1 in 5 chance your magic will level up. So I just keep using heal so that I can get cure up and going. And it's still shit. By the end of the game, it was still a shitty spell. So I had stocked up on all the potions, all the high potions, and before I was even halfway through the final dungeon, I was out of supplies. So, I was hurting bad, and I'm like, I don't know what the fuck this game wants from me, but I'm like, I can't give it anymore. And I think the last part of my Final Fantasy II playthrough is like a half hour long, because the previous playthrough is like 3 hours, maybe 3.5 or so. And I had mentally given up. I was like, I cannot do any more of this. I am breaking down. I'm like, I know I'm in the final dungeon. I know the final boss is just ahead, but I can't. I can't. And so I took like 3 or 4 days off. And then I came back and beat it within 30 minutes and was like, oh, thank God, this fucking game. And yeah, it's something that I may actually go back and rewatch myself to see just how pissed I was getting. And I forgot to switch over his lance. And that's right. I can't use magic against this guy. Oh, God. Oh, this game. Not this game, but this tower. Jesus, this tower. Yeah, I've never actually played Legend of Dragon. One of my friends in Florida swore by the game. He's like, it's one of the best games ever made. And, not that I was disagreeing, because I don't have the experience to know. But I was just like, okay, cool. And correct me if I'm wrong, didn't they remake Legend of Dragoon recently? Yeah, and that's just it. There's great games. There's some great games, but there's always those parts that it's like, oh, just thinking back to them just makes me so, so upset. Two things that pop to mind when I think of, great games that have those parts. Final Fantasy X, the temple-like block puzzles. Oh, those drove me insane. We'll get to those, folks. We'll get to those. There's... yes?
Headphones? Oh.
Yeah, you have them?
Yeah, I
okay. Then, I don't know if you played it, Kilo, but there's the original God of War game for the PS2, which, great series. That series is so good. There's a part near the end where essentially you die. You go down to Hades, and you have to climb your way out of Hades, which is like a really cool idea and a really cool scene. There's this part where you have to climb this rotating tower, and every section of the tower has a new obstacle. It's like, oh, this is like a poison section, and then a spiked section, and then like a, like bricks will come at you and you'll fall, and it's like most of the tower is fine. There's like a pattern to it where it's like, okay, I got this. But then there's a part of the tower where it's like, it moves erratically. So there's like no pattern. It's just a, you got to get lucky. And I have spent hours on that particular part, just trying and failing. And, you know, maybe that's something I'll do on stream someday, but wow. Let's, let me take a quick gander here. Dragoon. Okay, I must be thinking of something else then, because, yeah, there hasn't been a remake. They apparently just put it on PS Plus within the past year, which, I mean, is cool. You know, the more people who get exposure to it, you know, is it's definitely a good thing. But, yeah, again... I think that's what I'm thinking of, is Secret of Mana, yeah. Another great, great game. Yeah, I can't tell you when we'll get to Secret of Mana, but it will be played on stream eventually. Helping my friend clean out a storage unit 3 or 4 days ago, and you know, we were talking about my stream, and he's like, oh, you know, when are you gonna play this, when are you gonna play that, and I'm like, yeah, you know, if, I mean, eventually, the answer is always eventually I'll get to stuff, just gonna take a while for some things. We came across his Super Nintendo games, and yeah, we were exactly. It'll be in there somewhere. Vekilo, you are welcome to join me for a Pong showdown on stream sometime. Going through his Super Nintendo games, you know, I was like, yeah, you know, I want to play this. There was, like, he had, like, ActRaiser, which is great. He had Breath of the Wild, or not Breath of the Wild, Breath of Fire 1 and 2, which I'm like, oh, these are so good. And, yeah, you know, just going through all these memories, you know, like, oh, you know. I want to play this, and then it's like we were looking through his Sega Genesis games, and like there's the two X-Men games on there, which are hard as balls, but they're so fun, you know. I just love it. I am going to go ahead and save state because I don't want to have what happened last time happen again. Yeah, I have mentioned it, I just don't remember if I've mentioned it specifically on stream or if it was, you know, me throwing out ideas to my friends, but when Final Fantasy Year is done, I'm going to be taking requests for a while, because I definitely want to go back and play games that I'm not familiar with, that, you know, that other people swear by. You know, like you were mentioning to me playing the Resident Evil Survivor in October, which is already, like, at the top of my list. That'll probably be the first game of the season. And I'm excited. I am excited for October. Then I've got a couple games planned for December for Mary Dignus. So, yeah. It's a busy year, man. I've got my friend Dean, who comes on with me sometimes. He wants to go through and play a bunch of arcade games with me sometime soon. And, you know, even, like, ports of arcades. He's the one I was helping clean out the storage unit. And he was like, so when are we going to play Streets of Rage together on stream? And I'm like, dude, whenever you're up here and ready to rock, we will play some Streets of Rage. And then there was the X-Men 97 show that just came out that I wanted to play the X-Men arcade game on stream, but I haven't had anybody play it with yet. So that's a tease for what's coming probably around the 20th of this month. Because the 20th is when my whole group gets together for Dungeons & Dragons. Dean and I tried to play an episode of on stream. Gotta keep Reflect up, because as I learned last time, as soon as he's almost dead, he just starts shooting out the Blizzaga, Fyra, all that tough shit, man. Good. Oh yeah, you use flare on yourself, you bitch. Fuck yeah. Got flare. Fuck that stupid temple. The tower, it's disappearing. Alright, now it's time to switch things back to the way they were. Blade. Okay. And we need to put the holy rod and holy lance on you. Holy lance! And save first and foremost. Yes. Fabulous. See if that works. Yeah, you're welcome. Oh, now let's go on down here and see Sid. Hey, can you close my door? Oh, kids. Kids.
You look bad. Yeah?
Oh, I already did that.
Okay, where the hell is Sid?
There he is.
Like, Jane, stop this crazy thing! Oh, my head's spinning.
Grandpa, you okay?
I think I'm gonna be sick. But first, the good news. While researching, we found a couple more techniques, so we can upgrade the airship with submarine functionality.
Really?
Of course, nothing's impossible for me. Come on, Mid.
Yeah.
Didn't I already have a submarine? Or did it not make the trip when the worlds merged?
Shouldn't take much longer. Well, you two really work hard. Grandpa blames himself for the world having ended up like this. But, I mean, it's not like there's anything he could have done. I know that. I think deep down he knows it too. But that's why this time he's so driven to see his machines used for peace.
And that should do it. Once you're in the water, press down, then the A button, and the undersea world is yours.
Thanks for everything, guys. Now get the hell off my ship.
Bartz, I can't fight for beans. In fact, about all I'm good at is modifying machinery. Even so, I've tried to do everything I can to help you out. The rest is in your hands.
Come on, guys. We can travel underwater now, right?
Aye, now we can search for the tablet underneath the waves.
Mid, take good care of your grandpa. You guys take care too.
No point in dabbling. Let's go.
So, four different places. Alright. Well, before we start exploring the underwater, I am going to do a quick bathroom break and refill my drink. So, we will be right back. Alright, and we are back. So let us go ahead and take off here. Okay, so there's a couple things I want to check beforehand. Again, I am quite certain there's a hidden town here somewhere. Thank you. There's three forests to the southeast, so that would be this one. Maybe it's something we unlock later. I really don't remember. Then I did also want to check, because Bahamut said he wanted to fight in North Mountain, which is up there. Okay, so it looks like we might need Black Chocobo to get in there. Oh, you know what? If I don't figure it out while we're on stream, then I'll figure it out off and then do it on the next episode. We'll see. Be where we go, because here's more fucking gargoyles. Too bad they're not Disney's gargoyles. That would kick ass. Next time it's Lena's turn, I'll show you what Holy does there, Kila. Oh, fabulous. See, it gives him a shit ton of life. So again, that means that Bartz is going to be useless, as well as Ferris. There we go. deeper than the bottom of the sea, yet enveloped by flames. One tablet rests. Let's go heal again. Flare and Holy are expensive spells. Try this way. Oh, that is lovely. Covered in goo. Seems a little quick for a save spot, but alright. Yeah, like, I don't think I can use Flare on everybody, unfortunately. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Like... Nope. Look. Jesus Christ. Oh, God. Guess we better kill you fast then. That'll do it. Do we have float? Float at time? Yeah, it's a time magic. Okay, we'll switch over real quick. Nailed it. Hey, dwarves. Fucking party. Let it go. There may be only 5 of us, but welcome to the Great Dwarven Kingdom. Hello! Know anything about the magic lamp? If you take it back where it's from, the lamp's power will be refreshed, Ali. Lally ho! Rally Bower is digging a tunnel, Lally. He said it would let you go around the world, but why would you want to? Fucking move, you lolly-holing asshole. Way to waste my lolly-holing time. Oh. Never mind, I kind of love you guys. Oh, the circlet would be so nice to give them, but then they'd lose all their magic. All their half magic. Optimize. 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 Well, thanks anyway, you jackass. That's kind of clever, I'm not gonna lie. Don't have float on anymore, so better switch. All right. Fabulous. So glad the first time that worked, it actually fucking wrecked everything. Where the hell are you taking my boy? That was weird.
Oh, you bitch. Not very nice at all.
Lost my microphone there. I have given a name to my pain, and it is that unknown fucker. I threw all three switches. Come on. Oh, Jesus. I really gotta learn to stop just attacking these guys.
Gonna kill you, nasty fuckers, you are so gross.
I don't think I mentioned it earlier when we were talking there about the Secret of Mana remake, but that's where the mana at the end of my username comes from. DIG are my initials, and then I was like, I can't just be Dig, you know, for my emails or whatever, so I was really into Secret of Mana at the time, so I put two and two together.
Oink, oink. Ixdeath sent us, oink. Told us to kill you, oink, oink. Orders, you know, nothing personal, oink. Oink, oink, oink.
Wow, y'all are nasty fuckers. And I'm sure there's probably one that's gonna heal the others. Make my life hell. These guys are undead, so... You fucks. So, okay, I definitely need to make sure I stay alive for the next fucking turn. It's alright, we ruled it out. Oy, 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 oy. fabulous. Time it gets to Lena's turn, it's just... ugh, it's over already. Definitely seems like we're gonna have to kill them all at once. And I think we went down here to talk to the other one. Never worried about it much until now, but it seems like something odd is happening above ground, Lolly. I'm sure a forest is above us. Yeah. Maybe that's how I triggered the fact that there's a town there now. Let's save again, just in case we die again, we won't have to... we won't have to talk to him again. Something. Always something. One. Two. Three. There we go. Alright. So... I definitely have to kill them all at the same time. When I use Titan, the green one takes over 4,000, the other two take 2,000. So, if I... Okay, let's do Golem. Let's have a little defense here. Attack him. Fuck. Oh, wait. Come on. Please. Fuck. Fuck. All right. Well, that at least tells me that the purple one is probably down to about nothing.
Please.
Yes. Thank God. Receive meteor. Fuck yeah. Boy. Yeah, what a fucking mess. Well, let's just teleport the fuck out of here. You just drown and die.
Yeah, I could probably hold my breath, but only for about 7 minutes.
Yeah, we're not gonna fuck around in there right now, then. Although, good for him. Good for him being able to hold his breath that long. I can hold my breath maybe 20 seconds. Sure, I've been here. Yeah, it seems familiar. Let's go see if we can get into that hidden town. Oh. Yes. The time traveler is living between dimensions.
Cool.
Gold hairpin back. Well, everything else I think we're good on.
This is the town that floats within the rift. That's why it's called the Phantom Village.
Neat. Since we're talking to you like this, does that mean that we're back in the real world?
Trapped between dimensions, time has stopped in this town. 1,000 years ago, I watched as the world was split into two. Afterwards, the village was sucked here. Have you been to the Phoenix Tower? I heard that a dead dragon went there and was reborn as a phoenix.
Cool. I have not.
The evil warlock Yuno tried to use the power of the void to make the world his. Instead, the void engulfed him.
Womp womp.
Junk. A strange bird wandered through town a while back. Hey, there's my black chocobo.
Hi.
Cool. Thanks.
Appearing and disappearing like a desert mirage. A town where 1,000 years pass as if a single day. Not a bad song, eh? The warlock you know was immortal, but he traded his immortality to obtain the void's power. Time has returned to our town. That can only mean the void is trying to return as well. I hear there's hidden stairwells and monsters in the Phoenix Tower. Try checking the walls.
Okay.
Give you something good, but not for nothing. First, you gotta, round the world on a yellow chocobo. How's that?
I think I'll pass.
I'm fairly certain there's a piano somewhere in this town. Not that anyone plays it anymore.
Righty.
This town has 2 merchants in every store.
Alright.
The fuck was that? I don't know that I like this town.
Okay.
very, very strange. I don't know, maybe I've got to get the fourth tablet before I can get the chocobo. It was kicking us out of that room kind of the same way the fork tower was, too. Shit, I didn't switch her back over. Oh, that's bad. Fabulous. protected by water beyond its falling torrents, one tablet rests. Zap. I should put the Thin Mints away. Good news, I found the dead end, everybody. So that's a door. And that's... Hey, look, I already have one. Let's try this way. Poison, poison, poison. Rune blade. I guarantee my Excalibur is better than that. Oh shit. Not certain we even want to try this. 3 9 3 9 3 I think this is the first Tonberry we fought completely in Final Fantasy here. So all I know is he's a little fucker and will destroy us if he gets any closer. Dude, I really need you to fucking drop already, please. Oh, thank God. Ah, balls. Whoops. I kind of thought that skull switch would screw us over, so... Forget the chest. I don't care. You can keep it. I don't care. I don't care. Phoenix down. Reflecting. Thank you. That worked out, because I didn't actually mean to drop down there.
That tablet, you'll hand it over to me. Once Lord Axdeath gains the power of the void, he'll create a world for us monsters. I won't let you interfere. It's like if Sacha Bob was a demon. Oh shit, Leviathan's like, not today, bitch.
Beast was destroyed by Leviathan, and I have a feeling he's gonna want to fight. How you doing, buddy?
The power of my water is strong enough to wash away all sins and make all things pure. But only to those with the ability to fight the void will I award this power.
God. Oh my God. Wow.
Do I have to fight Leviathan right now? Because it seemed like I could walk away. Okay. All right. Fuck all these extra items, I don't care. Whatever.
All right. That is good news, because I was like, if I have to fight Leviathan now, then I would have to end the stream, because I would need to grind for a while. That's good. We can move along and we'll see what we can get done. Yeah, now we have all four tablets, which means we can unlock all the sealed weapons. So that's what we'll do. Of the way. Stop harping on me, Apollo. I heard there was an earthquake down south. We can only hope that no one was hurt. No one knows the cause of the earthquake. I wonder if some underground volcano erupted. If only we had a submarine, we could go take a look, but... But I don't want to. No, I don't need you to read the book.
not certain where it wants me to go.
Oh. Alright, well, let's go ahead and save before we even get there.
Yeah, some incredible force coming up from the sea floor.
Yeah, it's like time and space have been twisted. It's sucking us in.
Yeah.
Ouch.
You finally arrived.
Come on, let's check it out.
Cool. The door slams shut. It won't open, it's been sealed by mysterious power. Resting within the shard is Oracle. Gladiator. Cannoneer.
Yeah, I'm a traveling merchant, ever searching the world for rare and wonderful items. Recently, my ship was caught in a big storm and I washed up here. On the bright side, a mysterious cavern under the sea is just bound to be full of great loot breeders, so I figured.
Oh, you kids have got them crystal fragments, eh? That's the rarest of the rare. Oh, and it seems you don't even understand what powers are hidden inside those shards, huh?
Alrighty then, I'll tell you. First are oracles. They have the power to predict, foretell any helpful or harmful phenomena that will happen to themselves or those around them. Earthquakes, tsunami, illness, all those can be predicted and be made to befall all enemies. But be careful, sometimes they'll affect the oracle himself. As for the necessary conditions to spark each phenomenon, well, that's something you'll have to figure out for yourself. Predictions come in three ranks. Higher ranks take longer to come true, but have much more drastic effects. It's like they say, good things come to those who wait, right? Anyway, after a little practice and maybe a little luck, to effectively use and predict will be a breeze. Next, we've got gladiators. Gladiators fight like they were born with a blade in their hands, but between the blade blitz technique and their finishes, they've got the power to take down almost any foe. Last but not least, the cannoneers. These explosive experts use their abilities to combine to always get the most bang for their buck. Combined, the less cannoneers put together ammunition with various other items to cause different effects. Those are three types of ammo. Buckshot, blastshot, and blitzshot. Try combining different ammo with different items and see what happens. Actually, I'd love to help you guys get started by selling you some ammo right now, but I'm also there. How about this? I'll go talk to my supplier, and then I'll be more than happy to help you with all your ammunition needs. I'm always on the go, so look for me when you're in towns or castles. I'm usually lurking around the equipment shops, gotta keep tabs on the competition. I hope this is the beginning of a beautiful and profitable relationship. See you around!
It's like, what the fuck was that about?
I'm assuming this is just extra added shit from when they remade it for the Game Boy Advance. Probably nothing we have to worry about too much.
Thank you. Alrighty. Well,
so to be 100% honest, I think at this point it's just a matter of we fight Leviathan, then Bahamut, and then go into the void. Again, in order to even fight Bahamut, or Leviathan, I'm going to need some major grinding. Anything down here?
Hey, let me out of here!
So, I'm going to go ahead and land for a minute. Oh, level 37, 36, and 38. Alright, so what I'm thinking is if we get up to about level 45, then at that point we should be good to proceed. Again, it's kind of frustrating because this game definitely seems like it doesn't want to give us much opportunity to actually level up. I think what we're gonna go ahead and do is we'll go ahead and end now, since we are coming up on about 3 hours. I will start grinding in all my free time so that hopefully within the next few days I'll be about level 45, maybe even level 50, you know, just depending on what information I find out. But until then, we'll call it a day, and we'll continue on next time. As usual, I thank you all for being here, for hanging out with me. I couldn't do it without y'all. Thank you for being here, and y'all take care, okay? We'll see you next time.